Hi everyone, welcome to My Max Academy. In this video, we'll continue with the chapter determinants, which is chapter 4 from your 12th standard CBSE Mathematics. I'll start with exercise 4.6 in page number 136 of your textbook. I'm going to do the first problem, which is examine the consistency of given set of equations. So there are set of equations given. We need to tell them whether they are consistent or inconsistent. Fine. So again, I'll write the condition for the consistency and inconsistency. So here, if determinant of A is not equal to 0, first one, then it is consistent and it has unique solution. Then second is, if determinant of A is equal to 0 and adj of A into B is not equal to 0 matrix, then it is inconsistent. Then it is inconsistent, then no solution. The system of equations are inconsistent. Suppose third is, determinant of A equal to 0 and adj of A into B is equal to 0, then it is either consistent or inconsistent, which means it will have either infinitely many solutions or no solution. Either it will have infinitely many solutions or no solution. Fine. Now we'll have to check these conditions for the first few problems. So first problem is x plus 2y equal to 2 and 2x plus 3y equal to 3. So x plus 2y equal to 2 and 2x plus 3y equal to 3. Now we need to check whether it is consistent or not. So first one is, we have to write this in the matrix form. So if you take A as the coefficient matrices, which is 1, 2, 2, 3, all the coefficients, your A matrix, and your X matrix is X, Y, and your B matrix is 2, 3. Now let's find what is determinant of A. Determinant of A is equal to 1 into 3 is 3, minus 2 into 2 is 4. So 3 minus 4 is minus 1, so not equal to 0. So since determinant of A is not equal to 0, therefore it is consistent. Consistent, that's it. Therefore, the given set of equations are consistent. Fine. Now, the second question. The second question is, I will do the third question. So, second, you can do it yourself. Same way, you have to check whether, you know, whether it is consistent or inconsistent. So, third one I will do. Third one is x plus 3y equal to 5. 2x plus 6y equal to 8. Right, now we need to check whether it is consistent or inconsistent. So again, A matrix. So solution is, let's write A matrix. A matrix is equal to the coefficients 1, 3, 1, 3, the coefficient of x and coefficient of y, 2, 6. And your X matrix is capital X is X, Y. And your B matrix is 5, 8. Now let's try to find what is A determinant of A. Determinant of 1 into 6 is 6, minus 3, 2 is 6, which is 0. Therefore, A is a singular matrix. When the determinant of A is 0, we call A as a singular matrix. Then we should find what is, the moment determinant of A is 0, we have to find adj of A into B. Let's find what is adj of A. Adj of A for a 2 cross 2 matrix is, we have to swap these two. So 6 will go there, 1 will come down. So 6, 1 to find the adj of A. 6 will go there, this is a short form. 6 will go here, 1 will come down. Then other two numbers, keep it as it is, change only the sign. So minus 3, minus 2. So this is your adj of A. Right? I have to put the minus for these two, then swap these two. Now what is adj of A into B? Matrix that is equal to adj of A is 6, minus 3, minus 2, 1 into B matrix. B is 5, 8. So 5 and 8. Now, if you do this multiplication, 6 5s are 30 plus, sorry, minus 24, 6 3s are 24. Then 2 5s are minus 10 plus 8. So, you get 6 minus 2, which is not equal to 0 matrix. So, your adj of A into B is not equal to 0. So, therefore, it is inconsistent. The system of IP equation is, it is inconsistent, which means no solution. It is inconsistent. Fine. So, all of you can pause the video and take the notes. I will go to the next one, which is fourth problem. Again, we have to check the consistency or inconsistency, but it is a 3 cross 3 matrix or a 3 equations and 3 variables. So, fourth problem is x plus y plus z equal to 1, then 2x plus 3y plus 2z equal to 2, then ax plus ay plus 2az equal to 4. Right, the first step is solution for this. We have to find what is A matrix. Write the A matrix, the coefficients 1, 1, 1, then 2, 3, 2, then A, A, 2A. Then our X matrix is equal to X, Y, Z, small x, small y, small z. Then your B matrix is 1, 2, 4. This matrix 1, 2, 4. Now let's find what is our determinant of A. So, determinant of A is equal to, now we have to, we can expand through row 1. So, 1 into, this will get, this will be close, this will be 3 into A, 6A minus A into 2 is 2A, minus 1 into, minus this 1 into, this will be closed, this will be closed, 2 into 2, 4A, 2 into 2 is 4A, minus 2 into A is 2A, plus 1 into, again this will be closed, this will be closed, 2 into A is 2A minus 3A. So, this will become 4A. This is 2 minus 2a, this is minus a, so you will get finally a. So, final answer is a, your determinant of a is a, small a, and that is not equal to 0. Why small a is not equal to 0? Suppose if small a is 0, then it will become 0, this will become 0, this will become 0. How can 0 plus 0 plus 0 equal to 4? So, which means a is not equal to 0. Fine, so a is not equal to 0, therefore small a is not equal to 0, therefore determinant of a is not equal to 0. So, when the determinant of a is not equal to 0, we call it as, therefore, it is consistent. It is consistent, so, which means the given set of equations are consistent. It is consistent and you will get unique solution. That's fine. Fine. So, all of you can pause the video and take the notes. I will go to the next section. Next problem, which is problem number 5. Fifth problem. So, problem number 5. So, the given equations are 3x minus y, 3x minus y minus 2z equal to 2, 2y minus z equal to minus 1, 3x minus 5y equal to 3. Fine. So, this is the equation that is given. And we need to check whether it is consistent or inconsistent. Now, let's write the coefficient A matrix. So, what is A matrix? 3, minus 1, minus 2, 2, sorry, 0. X is not there. No, X is not there. So, 0, because there is no X. Then, Y coefficient is 2, Z is minus 1 and X is 3. There is no, Y is minus 5. There is no Z. So, 0 equal. Then, that is your A matrix, and your X matrix, capital X matrix is X, Y, Z, and your B matrix is 2 minus 1, 3. 2 minus 1, 3. Fine. So, now we are going to find the determinant of A. First thing is determinant of A, the solution this is. So, determinant of A is what? Equal to, we will take this. So, 3 into, close this, 2 into 0, 0, minus 5, minus into minus, plus 1 into, close this, 0 plus 3 is 3, minus 2 into, so close this, 0 into minus 5 is 0, minus 6. So you get minus 15 plus 3 minus into minus plus 12. So you get 0. So determinant of A is equal to 0. So the moment determinant of A is equal to 0, then either it falls into either second or third. It is not the first one, either second or third. Now we should find what is H of A. Now we should find what is it. What is H of A? H of A is A11, A12, sorry, A12 should be here. A12, A13. You have to be careful. A2, you have to write a transpose of that. A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. So this is your H of A, where A11, A12 all cofactor of the respective elements of A. Now let's try to find what is A11, A12 and all. So let me erase this. What is A11? Let's find what is A11. So our A11 is equal to M11. That is equal to, so we'll have to close this and this. 2 into 0, 0, minus 5 into 1, 5, so minus 5. Then A12, that is minus M12, that is equal to minus of M12. M12 means this one. So close this. 0 minus into minus plus 3. 0 plus 3 is 3. So it will become minus 3. So A13 equal to M13. That is equal to, you have to close this and this. First row and first third column. 0 into minus 5 is 0. Minus 2 threes are 6. So you get minus 6. Fine. The next one is, I'll write here. A21. That is minus M21. That is equal to minus of M21. So we'll have to take this element. So we'll close this particular row, this particular column. If I close this and this, minus 1 into 0, 0, minus 5 into minus 2 is minus 1 into 0, 0, minus 5 into minus 2 is minus 10. So you get minus 10, which will become 10. This A22 is M22. That is equal to, we'll close this particular column and this particular row. So this column and this row. So 3 into 0. 0 minus 3 2s are minus 2s plus 6. So you get 6. Then A23 is minus M23. That is equal to minus of M23. M23 means this one. This will go, this will go. Minus 15 plus 3. Minus 15. So I'll close this particular row and this particular column. So 3 into minus 5. Minus 15 minus into minus plus 3. Minus 15 plus 3 is minus 12. And already there is a minus, so it will become 12. Then let's find A31 is equal to M31. That is equal to, so close this, this row, this column. 1 plus 4. 1 plus 4 is 5. Now A32 equal to minus M32. That is equal to minus of M32. Close this. 3 into minus 1, minus 3, and this is 0. So you'll get minus 3. So minus of minus 3 is 3. Fine. So then M33, that is equal to, close this, 6. Fine. So now your H of A becomes your H of A. H of A is equal to A11, that is minus 5, minus 3, minus 6, then 10, 6, 12, then 5, 3, 6. 5, 3, 6, right? Now we have to find what is H of A into B. What is H of A into B? That is equal to minus 5, because we need to check whether it is. If it is not equal to 0, then it is inconsistent. Not equal to 0 matrix, then it becomes inconsistent. So minus 5, minus 3, minus 6, 10, 6, 12, 3, sorry, 5, 3, 6 into B. B is what? That matrix. 2 minus 1, 3. This is your B. 2 minus 1, 3. Now multiply. So if you multiply, you will get minus 5 into 2, minus 10. This is minus 10. 5 threes are 15. right? So now here itself we can say it is not 0. So your minus 10 minus 10 is minus 20 plus 15 is minus 5. It's okay. We'll do fully minus 6 minus 6 plus 9. Then minus 12 minus 12 plus 18. So that will give you minus 5. Then this is minus 3 and this will become 24. So minus 6. Right, and this is not equal to 0. Therefore, your adj of A into B is not equal to 0. Therefore, it is inconsistent. Which means the given set of equations are inconsistent. Therefore, the given set of equations are inconsistent. Fine. So here we will just say whether it is consistent or inconsistent. We don't have to solve and find. We don't have to solve and find. That will come in the next section. That will come in the next set of problems. Problem number 7 and all, we will do that. So this is your 5th problem, and I will say 6th problem, you can do it yourself or homework. Same way, we have to check whether it is consistent or inconsistent. The first step is you have to find determinant of A. If determinant of A is not equal to 0, then immediately you can stop and say it is consistent. You don't have to solve this, because problem number 1 to 6 is just to examine whether we should say whether it is consistent or inconsistent. That's all. And we need not solve them. We'll do solving them. We'll do it in the next set of problems, which is from problem number 7. We'll do it. So all of you can pause the video, take the notes. I'll stop the video here and you can watch my next video for the continuation of this. Thank you for watching. See you all in the next video. Thank you.